Here we are for round one. This hand is fairly awkward. It's pretty good if I just draw a land. I guess it specifically has to be like a forest. I can play this and then hopefully draw a swamp later, so it's probably not great. Yeah, I'm gonna mulligan. So I'm on the draw, so it helps a little bit. Ugh. I'm gonna mulligan this one as well. It's just not doing much. Okay. This one also pretty bad, but that swamp certainly helps. Possible our mana base is a little ambitious, but it didn't feel that way. My opponent's not really doing anything, so that was a great draw. Shoot this guy. I thought this was a different card. We are also not doing anything, so you know, there's that. It means he probably also just has six spells in hand. Or, I guess that's not true. He probably has more lands. But, I mean, his spells are all, like, good spells, rather, is what I meant. My draw item turned out to be not too bad, though. Like, compared to what he's doing, at least. I'm going to get to play Brood Butcher next turn. He might have, like, a counter spell. So, if he just passes again, I'm probably just going to play this other Nullcaller. Could have like, okay, I guess that makes sense why he wasn't playing anything. He could have like Horribly Awry, but that doesn't counter Brood Butcher, so. So I draw land next turn and I just play both my creatures. What's this? Ugin's Insight, okay. The Scry 3, draw 3, but he's not really progressing the board at all, so that's not terrible for us. He's already played a land. Is it a 1 drop? Oh, okay. So I could attack with my Brood Butcher, and if he double blocks, use my Scion to basically just kill his Reflector Mage. It's -2/-2, right? Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And then post-combat, just play a Nullcaller. I hope he just doesn't block, so then I can just play both of these creatures, but... There we go. I can pump the Stalking Drone if I absolutely need to by sacking the Scion. I think it's unlikely I'll do that, though, just because the Scion's just another body to throw away to my... Brood Butcher here. Planar Outburst would be pretty bad. Cyclone Sire, okay. Well, I don't really care about that because I'm going to have a Bluegan Strike in hand. Okay. Sacrifice another creature? No, so I can sacrifice itself if I need to. So I'm definitely going to strike this. And I think just attack with all of my creature. Well, not my Scion, because the Scion's, like, if he just blocks Reflector Mage, I don't want to, like, sacrifice my, you know, Stalking Drone to kill it. Smash with these two, and then if he blocks with the Reflector Mage, I'll just sack my Scion to give it -2/-2. Actually, if he just does this, I'm going to sack it to pump my Stalking Drone so then I can have 2 mana up in case something else goes wrong. opponent does have a lot of cards in hand, so. Okay, that doesn't really do too much. Okay, that's a little more annoying. I'd love to draw a colorless source. Oh, that was pretty bad. So I could attack with both my guys, and then if he... What? If he double blocks my null color, I can just give this minus two and kill it. And then make a zombie out of my Brood Butcher, so that's not terrible. So I don't have too many qualms about throwing my Brood Butcher away here, because I don't really have many other creatures, you know, so I'm not going to have many things to sacrifice. And if he double blocks my Stalking Drone, that's a lot worse for me. Maybe I could just attack with the Null Caller. And then if he just blocks with Warden, I can kill it. I don't really want to trade for his Warden, though. I really want to trade for his Flyer. I could just not attack, I guess. I could just, like, play Null Caller and pass. Because what... Yeah, like, if I kill his Jawar Isle Avenger, I make a 2-2, but he still has this 2-3 that's just bricking my team, so that doesn't seem very good. I'm just gonna... So I guess I want to leave up... I can't leave up double black, so... Yeah. I'm just going to play this Null Caller and pass. I'm going to play this Forest, because if I draw, like, Coastal Discovery into a land, you know, I want to be able to play that land so I can have more mana for my Brood Butcher. Fairly annoying. So if he attacks with the Warden, I'm just going to double block. Still has three cards in hand, jeez. That Warden's pretty big. It's going to be hard to get through that. Okay, that's... Would have been good last turn. I guess now I can still just attack and then shrink that. I mean, he does have a bunch of mana up now, but... I can't really just sit here. I mean, I think I'm gonna definitely try to kill it because I don't want it to get attacked back for three. The thing that deals 5 damage divided. Encircling Fissure, jeez. Okay, I guess that's not horrible because I don't lose my Stalking Drone. Wait. So he still takes. No, he doesn't take anything. So I was thinking it only prevents to his creatures, but it just prevents to everything, so. Alright. I need to draw Coastal Discovery. This isn't bad for a mulligan to 5 game. Now even if we draw Coastal Discovery, it's not looking great. I'm surprised he didn't attack with that plane, so we'd be dead on board to his Flyers. Ooh, that was a good one. Well, it was okay. And he can just, you know, it's just gonna trade with his 4/4 if he doesn't have anything. It's definitely a good draw, but doesn't quite get us out of the woods because he had another Flyer. Has a spell here. I mean, obviously a spell is... It only has two cards left in hand, but... He's likely to have something. Oh no, he's just sacking that now. Okay. Jesus. Okay, well, I can't trade for his Jawar Avenger anymore. Still trade for a Skyclimber, though. And if I just draw a way to kill this, which I guess Grasp doesn't do it anymore. So it has to be, like, the other, the 5-mana Grasp, Demon's Grasp. Because I don't... my other removal spell is Complete Disregard. That obviously doesn't do it. And we are dead. Alright, well... His deck doesn't seem great, so I think we have a decent shot here. Plummet's gonna be good. I think that's it. He's gonna board out like Grave Birthing. Doesn't seem great. Maybe a Null Caller. I don't really like that card at all. Witness the End might not be too bad here. I don't think I want it though. Okay, sounds solid. It's a little slow, but our deck's a little slow, so be expected. I have a colorless source and Deceiver of Form, so that's good. That was a solid draw. Now I just need some lands. Island or Swamp would be great. Swamp would let us cast Grasp if we draw it. Island obviously lets us cast that. That wasn't a terrible draw either, but I really need to not miss my fourth land drop this game. Hopefully this doesn't get Reflector Mage. Although it's not that bad if it does. Just annoying. I mean, especially if I miss my land drop, because if I can just cast Warden here, it's perfectly fine. All right, nice. Missing there and just having to pass would have been horrific, though. I don't think I'd block if he attacked there, but then he can't block my attack, so... I don't think I want to attack either, there's just too many... He was like, destroy an attacking creature. Although if he had that, he probably would have attacked to make sure I attack. But if he kills this, it's just so unbelievably bad for me, so... I'm just going to cast my spell and move on. I definitely want to cast this, because then if I draw land next turn, I can cast this. It's also just a 3/5, so it's much more likely I'm going to be able to attack with Translator next turn than attack with Brood Butcher. I guess technically if I played this, I could have drawn a land and played this as well, but I'd much rather just activate this rather than sacrifice my spawn. Okay, that's pretty annoying. Definitely going to attack. I'm just going to cast Brood Butcher. Blue Source would be a good draw. Shrieker, that's not terrible. I could cast my Deceiver of Forms. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I lose just a Scion, which isn't that bad. I'll just make an 8/8, but I'm a little worried. He has a lot of mana up, and you know, I passed like a Scatter the Winds. I passed. I don't remember passing a Spell Shrivel or a the Cancel in Oath, but. I don't think it's worth just jamming while he has all this open mana. Like, he's got to eventually tap mana, and this 8/8
likely just going to take over the game when I cast it. So I don't want to run it into a counterspell if possible. And it's not like my turn's bad if I don't cast it. You know, if it was casted or do nothing, I would probably just cast it. But I can, like, instead play a Shrieker and a Snapper, both of which, if I draw a land, can attack through this Reflector Mage. So first I'm going to attack with these two creatures. And if he has, like... If he has, like, Encircling Fissure, then I can cast this post-combat. So maybe I actually just shouldn't attack with Brood Butcher. I guess if I... Because if he has Encircling Fissure, he can't kill this. I guess he can't really kill my Brood Butcher either, because I can just give his land -2/-2. So, okay. And then I can just cast, like, a Shrieker. Immolating Glare. Well, I guess I'm that was bad anyway, because if he has Encircling Fissure, he has to tap out to do it, so I'm not really playing around that at all. I could sacrifice both of these creatures to kill that, but that takes up my turn, which I don't think is worth it. Yeah, that was bad. I shouldn't have attacked with my Brood Butcher. If he has a counterspell, I'd rather him counterspell Snapping Gnarled. I don't think he's going to counterspell either one, but... Even if he plays something like Ugin's Insight here, that takes him to less than 3 mana, so I can just cast my 8/8. This is largely that angel that we passed. It'd be annoying, but not the end of the world. He's already played a land. He doesn't even have anything in his graveyard to get back. Just a 4/4. Ooh, that's pretty good. I can still cast my Deceiver if I draw a land, and I'm sure that's definitely what I'm going to do. Lantern. Okay, Lantern's not terrible. 2, 3. I could play Lantern, then Shrieker. I could just play Translator. Unfortunately, I can't attack since I don't have a land drop. I think I want to play just Translator. Well, that's much worse against more bounce spells. No, I think I'm going to play Lantern. This is better against like another Reflector Mage or something, or anything else you might have like that. There's also a very real benefit to keeping this Scion around, because when I eventually cast this Deceiver, it becomes a real creature if I ever trigger a Deceiver. Jeez, just go, huh? I drew a land. I still don't think I want to play this Deceiver into all this open mana. So I think I'm going to give this Menace and then just attack with these two creatures. And then post-combat, I'm just going to play Translator. If he casts Fissure here, is that bad for me? That's fairly bad. It sucks he can cast Fissure and still leave up a counterspell. I mean, it's not the end of the world, he just eats one of my creatures. I'm assuming he's going to eat my Shrieker here. Yeah. Okay. Just gonna play Translator. I could also play Spider. I think I'm going to. Like I said, there obviously. So he's gonna counterspell this. So I'm glad we were playing around counterspell this whole time, because I felt like he probably had that scatter. Yep. Next turn I can cast this, and hopefully that's good enough to kind of take over the game. Also, I just, if I ever draw an island, I have this coastal discovery, which is going to be great. If I hadn't, that Brood Butcher attack was just so bad. Like, the whole game would be different if I didn't attack with that. I'd be in such a better spot. I still think I'm okay. That was a good draw, too, obviously. Ooh, maybe. Maybe I should cast this, and the next turn I can cast this, and then if I trigger it, I get a million creatures. I think I just want to get an 8-8 into play, though. Yeah, this all's just using my mana more efficiently. Though it really sucks if he has another counterspell. He definitely would have counterspelled my Brood Butcher. Unknown Shores, do I want that? I think I do. It lets me cast my Coastal Discovery. And obviously no attacks. This is also much worse against a Bounce spell. So maybe it was better to play Brood Monitor, but he's already used two Bounce spells. Might. Ugh. I think I'm going to have to trade with his land here. He still has three cards left. That's so many. So I can play Brood Monitor next turn. I think I'm just going to take it. So that will put me to 8. And then next turn I can play Brood Monitor and I can like double block. Actually, next turn I think I'm still just going to Coastal Discoveries and get a 4-4. No, I'm just going to draw so many cards. I'm drawing two cards and getting a 4-4 here, so I just want to trade off these while I, you know, just protect my life total as much as possible. Because I think with Coastal Discovery and Brood Monitor, going forward, I have, you know, like, I'm assuming better spells than him, but, you know, maybe not. So I'm just going to go ahead and Coastal Discovery here. Next turn, I can cast Brood Monitor and Netcaster Spider if I want to tap my forest here. That's pretty bad for me. I can exile his Reflector Mage. So I can play Oblivion Strike, attack for 4, and then play Spider. If I draw a 4 drop, I can cast that instead. And what else do we have? Blinding Drone. Ugh. I might need to exile that Blinding Drone. Wait, he's attacking? Does he know I have a 4-4? He's tapped out, and he already played a land, right? Alright, I'll block. Now I'm definitely going to just eat this Blinding Drone. I think he just forgot I had a 4-4. That's lucky. No, I think I'm going to play Brood Monitor still. 3, 4, 5, 6. I could play Brood Monitor and Spider if I tap that. I definitely don't want to I definitely want to attack. I guess I could. The question is, do I want to sacrifice a spawn to make a Spider? I think so, because I wanna start using my mana to scry, so I don't want to have, you know, the spider stuck in my hand. So on my upkeep, I'm gonna scry one. And then, you know, if I draw a creature, I can cast it, whereas if I still had Spider in my hand, I doubt I'd be able to cast the creature and the Spider. Is this the big angel we passed?
Yeah, there's the big angel. I really hope he doesn't have a plains. So he's going to Reflector Mage, our Forest. There goes most of my pressure. Now I have to exile this. Wait, he's attacking? I mean, alright, I'm just going to trade off my spawns here. I don't have any blue spells left, so I can just do this. I don't have any color spells left. I have Stalking Drone, though, so I guess if I play Stalking Drone, I might want to block and pump. Definitely do not want that. Well, that was not a terrible draw. Definitely have to strike this guy. And attack for three. He also just has this Blighted Step too, so I'm gonna have to get through that. Is he gonna double block? Okay. I mean, I'm happy killing his Blinding Drone. I'm glad they make that trade. I don't think I have any other allies in my deck, unfortunately. I think it's just a vanilla 4/4. But I didn't really have anything better to play instead, and still a 4/4. Yeah, I'm just with this Blinding Step, he's just gonna be able to gain so much life too, so it's gonna be really hard to race him. I'm gonna have to draw another powerful spell, but unfortunately I've used most of my powerful spells. I don't really want that. Soothsayer. Feel like he just always has so many more cards on hand than us. And probably because he's casting stuff like Ugin's Insight and Roiling Waters. Still my fault that I'm losing this game because I attack with that Brood Monitor, or Brood Butcher rather, that turn. If I just don't attack with that, I mean, I certainly wasn't like going to win the game for sure if I didn't attack, but I would just be in a much better spot. This guy is very aggressive. I guess I am at 8 life. It seems like he's just crushing me just by not attacking, though, because he has this Blighted Step. So each creature is just more life. Definitely want to scry. I guess it doesn't really matter. Put that on the bottom. Okay, that was good. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and cast... cast Grave Birthing. See what I draw. I guess it's possible I could have saved that to like ambush him, but I don't think that really does anything. Okay, so I have to pass again. Maybe if he just keeps trying to kill me, I can just like get him with his grasp. So I'm assuming he's gonna Blighted Step here. I think I want to save this grasp as a trick, rather than stop him from gaining two more life. So the card that would be decent right now is that 4-drop that I don't like, Void Caller. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 creatures in my graveyard. That would be great. Bottom, hopefully doesn't play another flyer. I guess if he does, I still have this grasp. He's only got two cards in hand too, so hopefully he just has lands. I mean, my draw should be generally better than his now, since I'm scrying every turn. And as soon as I find a Void Caller, I think I'm in really good shape. Basically just going to put every card that's not Void Caller on the bottom. That was a decent draw. It just gives me a little bit more, you know, of a safety net. So say if he draws the 3-2 flyer, I can complete disregard that. Then if he has another flyer, I can grasp that. Kind of in bad shape if he has another counterspell in his deck, so he can just counterspell my Void Caller. I don't think I can win if without Void Caller. I think I put 4 cards on the bottom now. 4 or 3, so there's 10 cards that I still don't know the order of. That certainly doesn't do anything. I mean, I say that, but it is just another creature. Eventually, if he just gets enough creatures, he can swarm around me. But I'm hoping that he kind of does get enough creatures to swarm me, and then I just get to, you know, use these 2 removal spells and then eat the rest of his guys. I really want to keep that on top, but I think I still just have to dig for this Void Caller. Yeah. Or null call, or rather. There we go. 4, so I can use it once this turn. Maybe I shouldn't have boarded one of these out in this matchup, just because it is... Well, last game it didn't seem very grindy. I mean, this game I just killed all his flyers, but... Let's see what this is. As long as it's not a removal spell, I'm good. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, I don't think we can win now. But, so I can't pump its power in any way, huh? I mean, I could kill it, but he doesn't have black mana, so he's not... it's not a good creature for him, but just the fact that I don't get it. I really wish I hadn't boarded my other one out now, obviously. I didn't see the game becoming this grindy since the last game he just killed me with a bunch of flyers. Okay. He might attack with his 3 guys now. Yeah. Or 4 guys. So I get to eat that, kill that, and then kill that. Just definitely don't want to go to 1. He ingested an island, that was lucky. Certainly didn't want to draw that. Alright, let's see. Don't want that. Don't really want that either. Can I attack him? No, I really can't. I mean, I guess I could kill the null. I really need to draw any spell there. Because I could kill the null caller and then attack for 6. But he attacks me back, puts me to 1. I could kill the Null Caller, just attack with my Soothsayer and trade. That's not horrible, I guess. I mean, I might as well wait till his turn to do it. So I can attack, and then if he attacks me with both, I can block the drone, disregard that guy. Unfortunately, he has the loot here. He only has 7 cards left in his deck. Maybe that's just how I'm going to beat him. I didn't even think about that. I guess that makes sense since he played Ugin's. They didn't even cast the spell. Jeez. Oh, shoot. God. I forgot to scry and obviously I drew a land. That's so awkward. 5 cards left. I might just kill him too. He's at 8. Yeah, this doesn't look good. This looks very bad. I'm 3 blue. Planar Outburst. So he did even have that. No, that just kills me. All right, well, thanks for watching. The deck was okay. I didn't expect too much out of it, but you know, it was a pretty good game too there. But anyways, hopefully you enjoyed the video and see you next week.